What's up, everybody? I'm Cameron Bertuzzi. You're watching the eighth video in a playlist of videos responding to 20 arguments against God's existence. The link to the playlist is right in the description. With that out of the way, let's get into the eighth video.
Who created God? And how does your answer to that make any sense?
No one created God. I mean, this video literally could have ended after about 20 seconds. No one created God. Does that make any sense? Yeah, it makes perfect sense. Now, I think this question actually does raise a more interesting question. Namely, if no one created God, then why not just say that no one created the universe? What's sauce for the goose is sauce for the gander. I'm definitely too young to be using that phrase. Anyways, this is the argument that Hemet should have used. So here's how Christian philosophers normally respond to this. God's being uncaused follows from a more fundamental property that he has, namely perfection. God is a perfect being. And it's actually incoherent to ask what created a perfect being. And I'll give two quick reasons for this. First, anything that could create a perfect being would have to be more perfect than perfect, but that's impossible. Second reason, whatever can be created can also be destroyed, but anything that can be destroyed, in other words, anything that is fragile isn't perfect. In the case of the universe, however, there's nothing at all incoherent about asking what created it. Sometimes skeptics and atheists respond to this by saying that Christians are sort of specially pleading for the God of Christianity or their God in particular. They're just sort of making up properties about their favorite concept of God and then saying that it's uncreated. But why can't we do that for the universe? Why can't we just make up stuff about the universe and then call it uncaused? Remember, the claim is that it's actually incoherent to ask what created a perfect being. Now, on the other hand, is it incoherent to ask what created the universe? And the obvious answer is no. Why? Well, here's one reason. If the universe began to exist, then it must have a cause. So if we have good evidence for a beginning of the universe, then the universe has to have a cause, and it's not incoherent to ask what created the universe. And at this point, you might be wondering, well, why think that the universe has to have a cause if it began to exist? The answer to that is that anything that begins to exist has a cause. I mean, you began to exist, right? I mean, I'm assuming you haven't been here forever. And you have a cause, right? Sure, you might think, but why does that apply to the whole universe? I'll give two quick reasons for that. First, there's no, and this is, a little technical, there's no relevant difference between individuals and groups when it comes to needing a cause. So for example, this lens that I'm holding has a cause. But what about when I have two lenses? What if I had a billion lenses? Would the need for a cause suddenly vanish if I start to add on more stuff? Not at all. And the same reasoning applies in the case of the universe. Just like we need an explanation for a billion lenses, we need an explanation for the billions of particles that make up our universe. Second reason is that everything in our experience that begins to exist has a cause. And that's about as good empirical evidence that you can get of anything. So for these two reasons, it's pretty safe to say that if the universe began to exist, then it has a cause. But why can't we just say that the universe has been here forever, that it's eternal? So putting aside whether or not like the evidence actually points that direction, let's just go ahead and assume that the universe is eternal. Does that make it literally incoherent to ask what created or what explains the universe? Not at all. Assuming you have one, take a look at your smartphone. I mean, you know that your phone hasn't existed forever, right? But just let's pretend that it has. Doesn't it still seem obvious that this thing has some kind of explanation for why it exists? Like, why does an eternal smartphone exist instead of an eternal computer? Why does it have the shape of a smartphone? Here's another more like technical way of asking this question. The category smartphones has at least one member in it. But the question is why? Why does it have one member? Why isn't it not just empty? It seems perfectly possible that it could be empty, so why isn't it empty? Saying the phone has existed forever is just sort of saying like, well, the category isn't empty. But that doesn't explain why it's not empty. And so now ask yourself, are any of these questions that I'm asking like literally incoherent? Do they lead to some kind of contradiction? Not at all. And so it follows that the universe and a perfect being or God are not on par when it comes to explanation. To summarize, we saw that it was really, 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 really easy to respond to Hemet's original argument. Who created God? No one. Does that make any sense? Yes. So then we looked at a more interesting, more philosophically interesting question. If no one created God, then why can't we just say the same is for the universe? First, I argued that it's literally incoherent to ask what created God. And then second, I argued it's not incoherent to ask what created or explains the universe. All right, that does it for this video. With 8 down, we're almost at the halfway point. If you enjoyed this video, make sure to hit like and subscribe to our YouTube channel. John McCrae has the next video in the playlist. You know, and actually, as we were splitting up these 20 videos to split between the three of us, between me, Mike, and John, I was thinking that the next video that John does, I was sort of hoping and relieved that it didn't land on me. So go check it out if you want to know what I mean. So if you're already in the playlist, just sit tight. You're going to be taken to the next video immediately. And if not, the link to the playlist is right in the description. See you guys in the next video.